Welcome back to the Profit Puzzle to snag celebrity clients. I'm Angela Profit. I'm a celebrity wedding planner who's worked in the events industry for over 16 years. I've worked with some pretty famous people here in Nashville, Tennessee, and honestly, all over the world. Some people have asked me to reveal exactly who I've worked with, but as you'll find out, when you start booking higher profile clients, it's just not cool to spill the goods or the tea or whatever you want to call it. Confidentiality is a big deal. And the truth is, I started doing weddings because I worked my butt off and the celebrities knew that. And I can't say that I haven't made any mistakes because I've made plenty. But as I've applied each of these puzzle pieces in this series together, I got better and better at attracting great clients, maximizing my productivity, and growing my profits. When I first started planning events for family and friends, I had two other jobs, like careers. I worked in healthcare and psychology, and I was a gymnastics coach. And for years, I kept both jobs for stability while I planned events for fun on the side. But I knew event planning was my true calling, and I was scared to jump in with both feet because it's really, really hard to get a foothold in this industry. It's like no other businesses out there where you have continuously having to find new clients and getting past like the whole feast or famine thing. It's just really tough. And so I don't know if you've had a coach or studied the methods that most people use to make it through those tough times in business, but we can't really do that because usually the answer is having a promotion for existing customers or reaching out to your customer base and asking if they need more services. Well, if you're a wedding planner, your clients hopefully only get married once. We've had a few repeat clients. And sure, they may hire you for huge birthday parties, anniversary parties, but come on, let's be for real. Like, these huge parties and galas don't happen every single weekend. So for me, once I started offering personalized services based on my background in psychology, the referrals started to come in, the right referrals. And clients felt like I connected with them on a really deep level. And they knew right off the bat, this was not a cookie cutter service that I offered to every bride who stepped through my door. It was really customized. And so I made all of my work all about them and I catered my approach to their personality. I really got inside their heads and honestly, they loved it because they trusted me and respected me as the expert in the industry. They were thrilled with the events that I designed for them and my team executed for them. And then, as technology got better, I added new processes to my business and eventually completely went paperless, and that transformed my productivity like none other. I got a lot more done and saved a ton of time. I was so efficient that I started to become a productivity coach, and I knew others could greatly benefit from the systems that I have implemented into my own business. And I've been lucky enough to travel all over the world teaching productivity tips, and I've helped a ton of entrepreneurs make money and bigger companies grow their profit. And it became my personal mission to help grow my business and your business too. So let's jump into the last piece of the profit puzzle to snag celebrity clients. So piece number 5 is production. And as event planners, you know it's so important to have a killer event. But what separates a talented event planner from a world-class event planner? How do you become the best? Because celebrities and millionaires and billionaires, pro athletes and CEOs, they only hire the best. And the truth is, the world-class planner might not be nearly as creative or talented as the other, but they'll get high-end clients more often due to one simple thing: mastering the fundamentals. You need to master communication, number one fundamental. And that creates a personalized service based on personality type. And there's one more type of communication that you can use to elevate your services and your production. And paying close attention to the details, especially on design day. You've got to watch and take note of what excites them, what makes their eyes light up, what makes them cross their arms and get super defensive. Up to 65% of all human communication is done through body language, and it reveals a lot more than our words do. You need to be the expert at reading the body language of your clients. And if you pay attention to what your client is saying without their words and their body, you'll have a much easier time producing the wedding that these brides are dreaming about. The other fundamental that makes you the best is executing a completely flawless event. You've got to run the event smoothly and hide any issues that pop up for your client. That's really wedding planning 101, right? So why do so many planners get this wrong? I hear stories all the time about event planners who stress out their brides with catering problems and flower issues and even like silverware mistakes. Guess what? They don't care. They don't need to know. It's your job to troubleshoot the problems, keep them hidden, and move on. Your team should be able to take care of it, even if you're not there. And think of yourself as a magician. The magic is in the clients and the guests not knowing the tricks behind the scenes and fixing all the weird stuff, last minute problems without them is even better. If you hire the best people and train them right, then you should have a superhero team ready to help you clear up any issues that come your way on a wedding day that are not planned for. And upskill clients, they hire you for your expertise. And experts, they get it done quietly and efficiently. No matter the craziness, what happens behind the scenes stays behind the scenes. And you'll shine even brighter if you take your knowledge of personality types and put it into the production. So for example, if you know that the DJ is a certain type of gem and he's about to pitch a tantrum before the reception begins, it's your job to shut that down. Using your knowledge of the personality types, you'll have a better chance of doing that without causing a scene or making the situation messier. So if you know how a person relates to the world, you'll have a better chance at diffusing really tough situations. This is the kind of knowledge that positions you as a true expert and a leader in your field. You'll have something up your sleeve that will always make it right. It won't always go your way, but your odds will be stacked in your favor. So that's why your high-end clients are paying you the big bucks. That's why. They're relying on you to use your expertise to put out fires without them ever even knowing there's smoke in the building. And I've had to do that before, real smoke. You also need killer execution skills. Everything needs to be perfect. You've got to find a solution really, really fast and learn to delegate it to your team members and use your attention to detail. Sweep the event before anybody comes in, just to make sure there's no problems. It's so obvious that many event planners gloss over this part, and it really hurts them in the end. You need to have a fantastic reputation, and if you want top-notch clients, you have to be top-notch. So don't leave this up to anyone else. Always follow up with your brides after their wedding. Give them some time after the wedding for life to calm down and contact them for a testimonial. And don't just ask for like a one-sentence review of your work. Ask deep questions so you can find out what you're amazing at and where you can improve. Don't get defensive. What did your client love? What constructive criticism do they have for you? That's how we get better, because people actually tell us. Being the best means facing your weaknesses head on and finding a solution to fix it. And don't forget to ask them if you can use their testimonial in marketing materials for social proof, because social proof is really a social phenomenon that makes the marketing magical and magnetic. It's basically a fancy way of saying that people are going to follow the crowd. I mean, think about it. So when you shop, do you look at other people's reviews before buying? And are you more likely to eat at a restaurant that has a 5-star review versus no reviews at all? I know that I'm that way. So you might think about adding testimonials to your website. Your advertising is kind of obvious, but the quality of your testimonials really matter. Dig into the details of what your clients love about your business. You can create a questionnaire for your clients to fill out and use those answers as a super powerful testimonial that gets noticed because it's all in the details. As always, the proof is in the pudding. The details can make a bride look as someone else or book you. And so that's super important. Follow up with a detailed review and make adjustments to your execution as needed based on that review. It'll transform the status of pretty good to like rock star. And now I want you to stay tuned to tomorrow because I have the most incredible news for you. If you love the transformation that I've shared with you over the past few days, this only has scratched the surface and you'll love what's in store. So stay tuned tomorrow and I'll send you an email that details out how you can put together every piece of the profit puzzle to create magic in your business this season and beyond. So you don't want to miss it. Until then, have a great day.